A Cup of Tea was a short story written by the prominent modernist writer Catherine Mansfield, whose original name was Kathleen Mansfield Murray. At first, this short story was published in a British pulp fiction magazine named Storyteller in 1922. Later, in 1923, it was published in Catherine Mansfield's collection of stories called The Dove's Nest and Other Stories. In this video, I am going to tell you the characters, setting, outline summary, round versus flat characters, narrator's point of view, style, themes, and moral of the short story A Cup of Tea. The main characters involved in this short story were Rosemary Fell, Mr. Philip, Rosemary's husband, Miss Smith, the poor little girl. This short story was set in 1920s in London. The story revolved around the character of a wealthy woman named Rosemary Fell. She spends her day shopping and spending money lavishly. Rosemary Fell, a very rich woman who was young, brilliant, well-dressed, and she was also fond of reading books. If Rosemary Fell wanted to shop, she would go to Paris. If she wanted to buy floss, she would go to the perfect shop in Regent Street, where she would buy only red and white roses, because Rosemary hated the shapeless flower lilac. Rosemary Fell had been married to a rich man named Mr. Philip 2 years ago. Her husband, Philip, would always adore the beauty of Rosemary Fell. Scene 1. Antique Shop in Curzon Street. One winter afternoon, Rosemary Fell had been buying something in a little antique shop in Curzon Street. The antique shopman showed her a little enamel velvet box. On the lid of it, there stood a charming couple, and more creatures were standing under a flowery tree. On admiring this, Rosemary asked the price of the little enamel box, to which the shopman answered 28 guineas. Eventually, Rosemary was shocked after knowing the price. She told the shopman to keep it for her so that she would buy this little enamel box next time she comes to the shop. By saying this, Rosemary left the shop by gazing at a tea kettle above the shopman's head. Scene 2. In Curzon Street. After stepping out from the little antique shop, Rosemary gazed at the winter rain that was falling from the dark clouds, and the people were walking hurriedly by hiding themselves from the rain under their umbrellas. Rosemary found her car waiting on the other side, so she had to cross the pavement to reach her car. Meanwhile, her thought was still on the little enamel box that she had seen in the little antique shop. Suddenly, a young girl who looked thin and dark was standing beside Rosemary. The poor girl requested Rosemary to lend her the price of a cup of tea. On hearing the pathetic condition of the poor girl, Rosemary suddenly remembered the adventure novel of the Russian novelist Dostoevsky. In order to execute the scenes that she had visualized in the book, Rosemary decided to take the poor girl home and offer her a cup of tea. Rosemary could have offered her the price of a cup of tea in the street itself, but she didn't want the act to be simple. Hence, she took the poor strange girl in a car to her home for the thrilling experience, and also Rosemary determined to prove the poor little girl that even the rich people had hearts. Scene 3 in Rosemary's house. Rosemary reached her luxurious house with a poor girl who asked her to give the price of a cup of tea. After entering inside the home, Rosemary took the little girl to her beautiful, cozy, big bedroom. In the bedroom, there were gold cushions, furnitures, primrose, and the fire at the corner. Rosemary asked the poor girl to sit in the big chair and told her to remove hat and wet coats. By saying this, Rosemary was going out to take the cigarettes from her clothes. On the other hand, the poor girl seemed very frightened and quickly asked Rosemary to give her a cup of tea. Immediately, Rosemary ordered her servants to bring her a cup of tea and some brandy. After hearing the word brandy, the poor girl almost cried out that she wanted only a cup of tea and not brandy. Rosemary lent her handkerchief to wipe out the tears and she slowly put her arms around the poor girl. Little later, the servants entered the room and served a cup of tea on the table with sandwich, bread and butter. The poor girl then began to tell Rosemary of her life until Rosemary's husband, Mr. Philip, came in. Although initially surprised to see the strange girl in their house, Mr. Philip recovered and asked his wife, Rosemary, to come and speak to him alone in the library which is in their house. Scene 4. Library in Rosemary and Philip's house. In the library, Mr. Philip conveyed his disapproval on the presence of the poor girl in their house. When Rosemary resisted her husband's words, hence Philip tried to kindle the jealousy and insecurity of his wife Rosemary. Philip told Rosemary that the poor young girl named Miss Smith looked very pretty. On hearing these flattering words from her husband, Rosemary considered the beggar girl as her rival in beauty and love. Rosemary did not want to lose her husband, hence she decided to send off the poor girl out from her house by just offering her £3 instead of £5. Later, Rosemary went to her husband and informed him that the poor girl, Miss Smith, would not dine with them that night. At first, Rosemary was intended to ask her husband whether she could buy the little enamel box, but then after a pause, she whispered in her husband's ear, "Am I pretty?" The story ends with this question. Rosemary, the protagonist, was caught up in a fantasy of helping the poor little girl, but it didn't go as she planned. In this short story, Rosemary Fell was a round character who initially showed kind and care towards the poor girl, but ended up as a hypocrite, whereas the poor girl, Miss Smith, was a flat character who remained the same throughout the story. This short story was set in third person point of view by an unnamed narrator, and the author used very simple language and conversational style. You can read this story in one sitting with only one main plot with limited number of characters and no subplots. And the possible themes that involved in this short story were appearance versus reality, charity, insecurity, jealousy, feminism, class distinction, materialism, hypocrisy, rival, selfishness, and poverty. This short story draws a comparison between both upper class and lower class. On one hand, the wealthy are enjoying everything in their life. On the other hand, lower classes are exposed to hunger and disrespect at the hands of the upper class people. Hence, charity towards the poor was encouraged. But charity, not by bringing a poor street girl into one's home, was not encourageable. Thank you.